So we started with the chest x-rays, and the chest x-rays, in my opinion, did not show any abnormalities in the heart or lungs. So the heart looked fine, the lungs looked fine, there was no evidence of cancer or anything like that. So because the heart and lungs looked good, we decided to go to anesthesia. We went to anesthesia and I started with the cervical spinal cord because that's where my physical exam yesterday told me where I should look first. And that's where the abnormality is. We completed the study, but I found the abnormality in the cervical spinal cord. So let's blow this up. It's actually a very low cervical spinal cord. Technically speaking, it's the upper thoracic, but it's...
So where's his head? This is actually his jaw?
I'm going to show you in a second. I just need to film right. So his head would be up here like this from the side.
Gotcha. So this is his neck right here?
This is his neck right here.
Gotcha.
This whole thing is his neck. So his whole body is not on.
Alien.
So what we're looking at here, let me grab a pointer. So this is the front, back, top, bottom. This is the spinal cord running through here. All this area is totally normal until you get to right there. See this?
It's a little divot.
Not only is there a divot, the spinal cord is narrow at that site, and there's a white streak right there.
The one in the middle?
This one right here. Oh, and the white streak right there.
Okay, yeah.
Yep, okay. So we're gonna come back and we're gonna look at that, but the way we're gonna look at it is when we move down into the thorax, because I wanted to center this more into the area. But this area of the spine looks fine. So now let's look. I'm gonna split the screen. I'm gonna try to. Into two.
And I get to go home with this on some sort of disc, and you're gonna send this over to my people.
I'm gonna send you with a disc. If you tell me where you want another disc, sent, we can send it there. I was gonna send them a report.
Okay.
Most veterinarians want to read the report. They're not going to take the time to actually look at the
image. Nor are they educated enough.
But if somebody wants one, I'm happy to make one for them. I don't like making them just to make them.
Yeah, I think, what's her name? Oh, my God.
Which one? What hospital?
Hold on. Dr. Maddie.
Dr. Maddie?
Yeah. I mean, everyone's going to be interested. They're all interested, actually. But I think she'll want to see it.
So now these images are, I think.
Sorry, Doc Matty.
That's
problem with filming.
It's funny.
Okay, so this is looking down, coming down through the snout from the front of the nose.
This is the same direction. This is from the side, but this is just a blow up of the same area we're looking at. This is the area in particular. This is going to be a cross section. So instead of looking at the spine from the side, we're going to take a cross section and then we're going to look down the spinal canal.
You're looking down the neck.
This way.
Yeah.
Yep, exactly. Okay. So, let's see.
That's so freaking cool.
What happens here?
Of course, now that you know, I mean, we'll get to the meat of what you think needs to be done. Yeah,
top, bottom, left and right. This is a rib. You don't see the rib over there. This is the bone itself. This is the vertebral column.
So where is this in his body at this point?
This is right here.
Gotcha. Great spot.
This is the spinal cord with a ring of spinal fluid. This is fat. This is a little bit of disc protrusion. And as I move this, look over here, as I move this orange line up into this problematic area, watch how the spinal cord gets compressed at that.
So we're coming up into his head.
We're going,
this is going north.
From his chest into his neck. That's correct.
Right. So to the ceiling.
Toward the head.
Yeah. In a human.
So watch how the ceiling. That's right, toward the ceiling of the person. So watch how the spinal cord gets compressed here. Watch how the fat disappears as we move to that area. This is going to get larger. And there it's gone.
So is that something pushing into it?
Yep. So what's happening here is the disc underneath is herniating upward into the spinal canal. It's flattening the spinal cord into like a pancake sort of shape. In addition, you see this white streak right here?
Yeah.
That white streak is a collection of fluid. I don't know if that fluid is in the joint here or in the spinal fluid there. It's very difficult to determine the two because they're right next to one another. My guess is it's spinal fluid right there. That's my guess. So what do I think is going on here? And now as we get past it, we start to go back to normal. Look at how much bigger the spinal cord is. Look how much smaller the disc is. And look how much more fat there is. So I'm going to quickly just kind of go through that again so that you can see all, you can actually see it get narrowed. Ready? This is like an old Mickey Mouse cartoon. There's the major compression.
And then we're going back down his spine. There's some fluid. We're heading toward his tail.
Now we're headed toward his tail, and then it's dilating, and then that's actually much further down.
Yeah, and so you obviously looked all the way to his tail.
I did.
And didn't see anything.
No, there are some others. There are some other discs, but this is the major one.
Let me take a pause.
Yeah, go ahead and pause.
Let me take a